Hey guys, welcome back to another very exciting tutorial of creating process. And in today's video we designed this logo, and this logo is forming a shape of heart, and in the middle we can see various shapes are subdivided in between, and each shapes are filled up with different shades of color. So to design this logo we'll follow three steps. First, we will clear up the basic idea of how to create these shapes using our basic shapes. Now second, we'll use the shape builder to create each pieces, and third, we'll fill up these pieces with different shades of color using our color palette here. So let's begin with our tutorial. First, we'll use the ellipse tool and draw out a circle and fill it with some stroke color. Now duplicate this with the alt and just drag, and make sure they are aligned like this, and you can shift a little bit more. Now once you have made that, we'll use the line segment tool, and from here make sure they are straight. So from this corner where the intersection is there till this corner, draw out a straight line segment. Now again, one more, from this, that's the anchor, with the ship rest straight, and from till here. Now we'll draw a few more line segments from here till this corner, from here till giving some space, from here again here giving some space. So once you have done that, you'll use the convert anchor point tool to make these points line segments go. Just do it like that, bring out the handles the same way from here for this, for the same thing here also, and do the same thing here, this line segment also like this and this. Now with the direct selection tool here, we'll edit the handles individually. So we'll select this, we'll just click and drag it out. In the same way, just click and use the handle and just drag it out like that, and you can do the adjustment a little bit if you want more like that. In the same way, we'll do this, just click and just drag it out, click and drag it out. So this one, keep it more curved, more nice flow, give it a nice flow. That, select this, use the handle and make it more curved. Here also make it more curved, like that. Here, push it out a little bit, like that. So once you have made the curve for three line segments, select all the three pieces, group it, and here, reflect tool, double click on it, make sure it's vertical and preview it and click OK, so it will duplicate it. Now just drag and keep this here, the pointer should be attached to this, the points. Now once you have done that, you can see it has formed a nice shape here. Now we'll do one more stuff here, click this. Now with the again anchor point tool, we'll just click and drag and make it a little more curve. From here also click and drag and make it a little curve. Now with the handle tool, that's the direct selection tool, just click and do some adjustment so that it look more symmetric. So from here, just make sure it's formed that shape. You can push it down a little bit from here to here like that, bringing these handles down, and it's form a shape like that. So once you get those shapes, now we'll do one more stuff here, we'll use one ellipse tool and draw one more circle from this point and just drag it out and make sure it's the diameter should be from this point to till this point, that's the length of the diameter. Once you have achieved that, just drag it up and make sure its points coincide here, all the points should be overlappings at this point. In the same way, we'll click and just drag, control Z, we'll select only the circle, with the alt press just drag it out, and you can make one more circle here and keep this circle here, that the point should be coinciding, and like this here also. Now once you have achieved all those shapes, now the next step is to use the shape builder to create each shape separately. So select everything, select the shape builder tool and just join this up. Now we need these shapes. So we'll select this, join this, this, this. So this is one object. We will see what shape we need here. We need that, we need this separate shape, this separate shape. This should be one object. Like that, combine it. This is one object, this is one object. This one is separate. The same way, we will combine this, this, this is separate, this is separate. So everything should be separate. So just click and make it separate object. So once you've done that, we'll select this and delete this out, and we are left with our inner pieces. So we'll just make sure the stroke is round here, corner, so that we can't see, we don't see the pointed edges at outside. Once you have done, select everything and fill it with some gradient color so that we can see all the small pieces separately. Now the next thing is to fill up with the colors. So to fill up with the color, we'll go to palette, color palette, and here just click the object, select the object with the eye picker, just fill it with the color. So we'll do that, selection, select this, fill it with the color. Now let's do the filling portion. So we'll select this with the eye picker, click, select this, click, select this, click. The same way, select this, click, select this, click, select this, click. Let's see what how it looks like that. This one, select this with a dark color, like that. So we can see we have filled that color. Now this side, we'll fill it. Select this, with the apical select, select this, this, select this, and fill it with the color, like this, light color. Now the lower, select this, this one, select this, this. Select this, fill it with some, maybe different color. Select this and fill it with this right color, this one with this color, maybe that color. So you can see we fill up that color, you can edit nicely. You can see we have seen small pieces here, we can just look it out. What's that? Okay, this one, okay. We can just join this up because it's form a space. So with the shape builder to just join it up, maybe like this, and fill up the color here. Also we need to do stuff, sometimes it happens, we have to just make sure it's there. Just select both of them and with the shape builder to just join them. Now fill the color. So select this with the eye picker, select that, we select this, select. So let's see which color we have left out. We have filled this, filled it, filled that. So we can see we have filled up all the color palettes. So we'll just rotate this to an angle, 90 degree, and scale this up a little bit. So we can see we have, after filling the color, it has formed the design which we have wanted. Now let's start fill it up with the text. So with the text, write out beat, B-E-A-T, beat, and let's give the font. So we are using NEX Nexa bold, that's our type font. And with the eye picker, just fill up the color, check, choose the color which we need for the font and place it there, scale it up. Here you can just increase the font size like that and just place it properly. So once you place that, that's how. So we can see we have designed this logo in very simple steps. First we had created that basic structure using our shape tools, and then the shape builder tool helped us a lot dividing these small pieces, and finally we added the font and the colors using our color palettes and the font family. So this is how we can create these kinds of logo. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, you can press the subscribe button. Thank you.